Yeah, right up there.
Yep.
Location number two.
Yep.
Typical.
Mm-hmm.
Another one right here. There's the antenna right there.
Yep. Connected
because
of the wire.
Wow, look at that.
You can tell from the box it's connected. It's still up, though.
What if it gets struck by lightning? Maybe it'll go off. There it is right there. There's controls over there. Check out the next one.
In okay condition.
Yeah, could be better.
Yeah.
Looks a little bit shinier than the other ones though.
Yeah.
The pole could do some work, but other than that.
Power line, as you can see.
Yeah, right there. All right, let's get a closer look. All you can see is that control box right there. Antenna right there. And there's this actual siren itself. And unfortunately, you can't get a close up of the other control box that's on the other side right there.
It's fenced up.
Fenced up like always.
Always.
A complete view of the whole building. Zoom up right there, there it is. There it is, right there. Right on top of there. Yeah, I don't think that one even has a pole. I think that one just
it's just on the roof.
It's just on the roof. No, yeah, it's because I figure it's like one of those roofs that are like not as high as like you see it. Actually looks nice. There's a control box right there. Right there. Alright, let's get a closer look. This one has no power. As you can see right there, this one also got cut off. Locked, of course. Okay, that right there. That's it right there. Siren number, who knows what.
Yeah. Siren number, who knows what. With a stitch or full of garbage, unfortunately.
Can't get a view of the control box, unfortunately. But there's the siren itself. There's the antenna. I assume it's back there somewhere. Yeah.
Right there.
I think this one might be in nicer condition than the other ones. Let's see. There's the siren. The controls are just right there. There's one control box. This one is behind the water division.
I used to live right next to it. That is awesome.
That is amazing.
Yeah.
And of course it's fenced, so you can't. But at least we can get a good view of the first control box right there. And as always, this one is cut off as well. There they go.
Yep. That was cool.
Yeah.
You know what? Let's bring the 521. No, what the heck? 521. 522 along. You know what? This will sound nice too.
What the heck? Oh, that was offside.
Same one, I
guess.
Yeah.
It's,
as long as it works.
Come on.
Oh shit, it's too loud.
It's too loud. Oh my goodness, okay.
That worked, apparently.
Oh my goodness, shut up.
This is real.
Turn down the volume a little bit.
Alright, let's try this. Still a bit too loud. Yeah, this is still a bit too loud.
Oh, I want to raise the antenna.
There we go.
Yeah, and this doesn't have a voice feature, so you gotta turn it off. Just press any button, yeah.
Cloudy. High 61.
I had it for a second. Wait a second. Maybe the cameras are too close. They usually. I just had it, come on. I hear it. Wait, oh, there we go.
Yep.
And that probably is W. No, that's a lie. I'm not sure.
I heard location and one bleeding onto two.
Yeah. It doesn't do that. The only time it bleeds is on channel 6. And every single radio has that tendency. Okay. Come on, I know we could get one more marine station. Oh. I hear something. Somewhat. Oh yeah, I hear something. Very faintly you can hear it. You hear that?
Very faintly.
Very faintly. Oh, oh, it was coming in for a sec. Alright. So it looks like we can get anything on this. So here's WXL 89.
Low Saturday night 49. And the high Sunday is 69. The forecast for Pacific Crest Trail, Tuolumne to Mono County line.
Wait a second.
Tonight,
Tuolumne?
Cloudy.
Wait, no, that's not the WXL 89.
Yeah. Miles an hour.
Saturday it should be. Night, kind of weird how they mentioned Tuolumne.
Becoming partly cloudy. South winds 5 to 15 miles an hour. Sunday, mostly cloudy. For Tuolumne Meadows, low tonight 28. High Saturday 59. Low Saturday night 26. And the high Sunday 53. The hourly weather roundup at 6 p.m. At Bakersfield.
No, yeah, that's the
BXA. Skies were partly sunny.
Yeah, I was about to say. Went off.
Did it?
Yeah.
Oh shoot. Let's try no chemical hazard warning.
Try watch.
Let's do our first watch. I don't know. Let's do a. Let's do it on this one watch.
All right. Actually, no, it's backup on. Yeah.
It's not one.
Try that one again, because let's see if this one will go off. Come on.
Nothing?
Nothing.
Oh no, I won't find one.
Nope. I guess it's off. Oh, it's off. Let's try channel one for this one. Oh, I know why that happened, because I heard it has the end of message detection.
Oh.
And because of that, it turns off the siren once it detects the first EOM. Yeah, pause it. Is there something up at your 120?
I don't know.
Oh, I think I know why this one is not going off.
Why?
The volume might be too high.
Oh, is it?
Yeah. Alright, I'm getting the signal. It's still a bit too high.
Message. Let's do something that recognizes it. I don't know.
Oh, this one works better down here.
Does it?
Yeah.
Not gonna put all of this in.
Come on. Try it again. Alright, the point is, this one is really hard to activate, the 522. Ooh, it went off after the second header. My recom has recently been going off after the first for some reason. And right there is radio's WR120 messing up for some reason. Tornado warning.
Perfect.
Your ETH is on low, isn't it?
Yeah, it's on low and low for some reason. Weird.
gears going up. Oh! Tornado watch. That thing is acting so weird.
I know. I don't know why, but...
Probably gotta get it checked soon.
Probably.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
Nuclear power plant warning. Let's do this.
National periodic test.
Yep.
And the one time that the 522 actually goes off and the others don't. Again, another MPT. Didn't go off for some reason.